According to Ziggy, there's a 100% chance that that Lost Ending footage is real, baby! It was real, I knew it was real, but now we have confirmation! So, I'm gonna be a little bit quicker getting to the point with this video, because last time people were a little bit mad with me, but I'm gonna make a long story short here and summarize it. Last year, I discovered photo negatives from the Lost Ending of the show Quantum Leap. Al is reunited in the future with his long-lost first wife, Beth, and he decides he's gonna leap after Sam, and it was going to lead into a season 6, which obviously didn't happen. So after 30 years of denying that this existed, we just had script excerpts, we had confirmation that it was at least planned, but the one thing that we didn't know was it actually filmed. Well, recently, footage surfaced on Reddit of this ending.
Parker. Yeah. Action.
Well, wherever Sam has leaped, he's still himself.
Because no one's in the waiting room.
Yeah, and we're gonna start a nanotech search in the morning, but that'll take months. By then, he will have leaped again.
What? It didn't take you months to find him.
I must have just got lucky.
Luck, Admiral Calavici had nothing. The two of you are so close, it makes me envious. You'll find him.
I'm not sure you're so sure.
Guess that.
Oh my god. I'm super excited. I'm excited, guys. Aren't you excited? We can see that finally it happened. So, big victory. This is a big W for us, man. Fellow leapers, celebrate with me. So now that the big news is out here, I'm gonna go a little bit deeper into what's happened since I released the video last year. So what ended up happening was I was doing some editing for the Quantum Leap podcast, which is a podcast that goes episode by episode over Quantum Leap and also interviews a lot of actors and writers and other behind the scenes people involved with the show and gets a lot of really cool behind the scenes info. So they asked me if I wanted to do an interview with Susan Dial, who plays Beth Calavici and was in the photos and in that final scene. So that was my first podcast with them and ended up leading to a permanent hosting position. So me and fellow podcast host Christopher DeFilippis ended up talking to Susan Dial. She was super excited to see the photos. She hadn't seen them before. I don't know if she'd thought about that ending in a long time. And it was really cool to be able to experience this with her as she was rediscovering this. And one thing that came out of it was confirming that she was part of the scene, not that there was any doubt from the photos. We talked a little bit about the process, doing like some aging makeup and some of the things with Dean Stockwell. One thing that she couldn't confirm was if this was actually filmed or not. She wasn't sure if this was a dress rehearsal or how far exactly that this got. So I decided to do a little bit more digging. I contacted the costume designer for that episode, who was not Jean-Pierre Dorliac. By season 5, it was Jacqueline St. Anne. And Jean-Pierre was nice enough to give me some contact info. Thank you, Jean-Pierre. So I contacted her, and she really did not remember a lot of it because she's worked on a lot of things. It's been 30 years. She recognized some of the things like the skirt and some of the silver that was being worn. She assumed that the denim that Dean Stockwell was wearing was just his. Which was pretty great. We also asked some other people during interviews that we had on the show since. They didn't really know anything about it. I don't think they were involved with the show by that point. They didn't seem to deny it though, so mystery deepens. So what do we know about this scene? Well, what we can gather is that this is an unfinished product on Reddit. This is from the dailies. You can tell because it's still got like a color checker on the front and the director saying cut. So this is just one take of the scene. Whether or not there was a fully edited version incorporated, I don't know. There was an interview on the Quantum Leap podcast before I was part of it from someone saying that they saw a completely different ending. I'm not sure if it was this ending in particular or how late in the game that this was pulled. Another thing is the audio is really bad. It's kind of hard to make out. But the good thing is we have the script for it, so we can put together via subtitles what's happening in the scene. It matches everything from that script with the "that's what friends are for." And that's also another confirmation, because there was two different lines at the end. There was "that's what friends are for" and some other line I'm not remembering. And we asked Susan Diehl about it, and she thought it might be that one, but she wasn't sure. So now we have a confirmation that's what she's saying. So there's still a lot of things to be answered, I think. First of all, why has this been such a secret? We don't know. I'm really curious to find out why this was such a hidden thing for so long. But it's really cool that this has surfaced now, and that we finally get to see this footage and wonder what if, what could have been. And also, there's another mystery to be uncovered here, some more footage, because there was another part to that ending. I mentioned it in the video that I did previously, but after Al leaps after Sam, there was another part of it where he ends up in the future as a woman, which was a really funny concept in this future space bar of some sort. But I thought from reading the script that this was just not a thing, because, I mean, it just seemed so elaborate and kind of silly, and they were denying that the other ending existed. I just felt that it just didn't seem like it went that far. But actually, fellow Quantum Leap podcast host Matt Dale got a copy of a script from actor Richard Hurd, who was in the finale and another episode of Quantum Leap as well. And in that script, it had that ending in the future bar. And it also had a key piece of information here, which was a shooting schedule. So that said who was on call, what day, and what was being shot. It said that on the eighth day, they scheduled that bar scene. And it had some other information about it. For instance, the people who played the miners in the episode were going to play the space warriors. There were space warriors in it, because of course there were. So what this tells us, if it was on schedule, and they got far enough that they were going to film all this other stuff, they had to have started building this and doing costumes for this, because there is a ton of space warrior costumes to do. That's for a whole crowd of people. This bar set would not be simple or inexpensive. I'm assuming they would have converted the bar they were using in the episode, but they had to have started some work on this for it to be at this point. So we know that they got that far. This kind of blew my mind, because I genuinely did not feel that this got past the paper. So to have this unearthed brings up more questions for me. I just want to see it. I just want to know. I know we're not going to get more Quantum Leap. That's fine. I just want to know. I just want to see the footage. It would be so cool. I asked Jacqueline St. Anne about it, because she would have had to work on the space warrior outfits, and again, she didn't really remember anything about it. We asked Richard Hurd as well. I don't believe he had any information about being fitted for the costume, or if he filmed the scene at all, so we don't know on that front. And he's the only person that would have been in that scene that we've been able to talk to, so there's a chance maybe someone out there remembers something about it. So that's the next piece of the puzzle to be uncovered. But for now, we have this historic find. It's so cool that we're still getting new stuff about Quantum Leap 30 years later. So I hope you guys find this as cool as I found it. I think this is just tremendous. I hope that this leads to other things being uncovered. I'm really enjoying this journey that we're going on. And if anyone has any information about that space bar ending, let me know. I'm very, very curious if there's any other things to unearth about that. But as for now, let's just enjoy the stuff that we got. This is a tremendous, historic, awesome, fantastic, over-the-moon news. So enjoy. Did I use enough descriptors there? I'm very excited about this. So I'll see you guys around. Bye!